Hey guys, welcome to Let's Talk Venture, the podcast dedicated to travelers, backpackers and explorers with thousands of stories. My name is Tony, and today and from the month of December, I will publish some extracts from previous interviews with the guests of Let's Talk Venture in this new format called Short Stories for Big Adventure. So here's an extract from the episode Random Conversation number 5 with Aiden and Lena from the CISV program, an anti-war summer camp, which they describe way better than I do.
So you say you are from Canada,
yeah.
Germany,
Italy, French, and so you are here for an international camp, right?
Yeah, so, well, we just finished it.
Yeah. In Lyon?
In Lyon.
Okay.
It's a program called CISV,
okay,
which stands for Children's International Summer Village, and it was started by a child psychologist after World War II, and he realized that at age 11, you start to realize that there's a world out there, right? So let's take this 11-year-old and we're going to send them to another country and they're going to spend a month in a summer camp with kids from all over the world.
You are not 11.
No, I'm not. So, but the idea started at 11,
okay,
right?
Okay.
So they make friends with friends from all over the people, with all over the world.
Yeah.
And then when they grow up, they're less likely to drop bombs on each other.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Ah.
So that it started with the 11-year-olds, and then it evolved to programs for 13, 14,
mm-hmm,
and we're all above 18.
Okay.
And so that's what we did for 3 weeks in Lyon this summer. And now we're actually doing our after camp. So everyone who could is staying at a hostel, and we're partying.
Now what I'd like to ask, during these 3 weeks, was there a what the fuck moment?
Oh, every day.
Okay, talk
day
to me.
Yeah.
Tell me all your secrets.
I remember one, it was not for a while, it was when Siri, the Finnish girls,
yeah,
like when it was the last night, we didn't sleep, and we went outside, it was dark,
yeah,
and you said, wait, it's dark, what time is it? Said, it's 4 in the morning, 4:20, 4:25.
Yeah.
Wait, why is it still dark? It should be day by now. And it's really disturbing because for you it's usual for it to be day at this early.
Yeah,
4 in the morning. It's like in the middle of summer, so it's in that forest, still the sun is shining already.
In Finland, this is
so
far.
Dark, yeah. And for me, well, it's normal thing. It was really fun.
Okay,
I'm trying to think of one.
Can I have this then?
Yeah, I know. It's difficult because there was no alcohol
always
involved.
Yeah.
Yesterday we had it. And yeah, we had like about food also, some like we had croissant.
Oh yeah.
Really fun. And we put like some stuff in your croissant. We're like, why would you put some ham in your croissant? Okay.
I was like, what?
They mettaient du jambon dans leur croissant.
Oh, it can be a recipe, actually.
Yeah, but yes. I was not used to that. Okay.
Yeah, all the French people were like, what are you doing?
No, actually, it's a recipe, like really to put ham inside
your ham, cheese. And I was like, oh, good. Like, yeah.
And you can do variation if you are vegetarian as well.
Yeah, like they're vegetarian. Cooking was very interesting. I remember the first, we were all in cooking groups, so like four people cooked the one meal. And at the first time I tried to cook, I put 5 kilograms of pasta in one big pot and tried to cook it, and I wasn't able to stir it. So most of the pasta got cooked, the bottom layer got burnt.
Oh, I had to clean it.
Hey, I cleaned the burnt pasta off the bottom.
Oh yeah, no, so, we had to take it out with a fork.
So yeah, we learned how to cook.
No, because cooking for 2 or 3 people is fine.
It's fine.
40.
Cooking for 35 people is
35 or 40?
35.
So
28 participants.
28 participants and 6 staff.
So,
okay. So 34.
Okay.
And cooking for 34 people is a whole other thing.
Okay.
When you're not that experienced in cooking, and like the proportions would rather have a lot or not enough.
Yeah. There was so many times when we were like, we would show up that morning and be like, what are we cooking today? I don't know. Let's see what we have. Because it was kind of a gong show.
Yeah, every day we'd improvise. Mostly ate rice and vegetables.
A lot of rice, a lot of vegetables. We had tacos so many times because tacos are easy. Yeah.
Always vegetarian, right?
There were three vegetarians. So we would always have a vegetarian option.
Okay.
And sometimes, I mean, there was a vegetarian in my cooking group, so we'd always cook like vegetarian.
Mm, yeah. And we would, every chance we would have, we would have people cook like cultural meals. So I had an Indonesian in my cooking group, so we had noodles. And we made sushi, and it was so good.
So wait a second. So you, for the organization of the cooks every day, you gather in groups of people and you cook by groups. Right?
So at the beginning of the camp, we would divide everyone up into groups, so four people, and then we had a schedule and say, okay, it's cooking group two for lunch on this day,
okay.
And cooking group three.
Oh,
and
yes.
Then in theory, you would plan what you want to have, and then tell the staff so that they could buy the food for you to cook. And that didn't always happen, but...
And because in theory, you have a thing and no one takes the food for their meal, in theory.
Yeah,
okay.
So most of the time it's like, okay, I needed this, but it's not there, so guess I'll improvise.
Yeah, because there's a pantry, and you could go and just take food from the pantry at any time. So I was like, there was very little organization of food.
Especially for midnight snacks.
Yeah. But it worked. So,
yeah. We ate every day.
Yeah. No one starved. That was good. Another really difficult part of the camp was staying up late, because there were some people that could stay up to like 3, 4 in the morning and then get up at 8 o'clock the next day.
Having no problem.
And just be fine. But yeah. So, but for a lot of us, it was balancing sleep and actually talking to people, because if you go to bed early, you can't. Right?
Yes,
everyone
so
got sick. Because we weren't sleeping enough, so there was just, yeah.
Every fruit night we would get at the end was just like nap time, and we would nap. We'd be like this everywhere we found every time we could.
What other activities did we do?
Okay, one more question. I love the fail story. Was there an activity that failed? Like really hard fail?
I was gonna say the one with human trafficking. So we had
exactly what you think.
So we I wasn't in the planning group, but
you
were. No, I wasn't.
I was gonna say I'm so sorry.
We had free time right before the activity, and during free time, one of the leaders went around and was like, "Lena, come here." And then they put a blindfold on them, and then we took them to a dark room, and they taped their hands behind their backs, and they would have to sit there
and
wait. And then there was another group of people.
It was me, and I didn't know anything. And it was activity time, so I went where we do the activities, and we were like 10 out of the 28. We're like, where the fuck are they? Are they sleeping? And then we're like, okay, we'll start the activity. I was like, okay, I guess they're sleeping, I guess they're sick. Well, okay. And there was like, mafia people who had to buy.
We had an auction for people.
And we were like, oh, okay, whatever, you know, like activity, sometimes it gets fun. And we took the fun out of it, but then they actually brought the other people out of the group.
So I was one of the people that was tied up. And I was sitting in this room tied up for like an hour. And so eventually we're like, so the activity is not really happening. I wonder if we're supposed to escape, because no one told us anything, right? So we're like, okay, I figured out how to get my hands free, and then everyone ran together. And so we all ran out of the room.
That was not supposed to happen.
That was not supposed to happen. And then there's a bunch of people like in another room, and that's where the auctions are supposed to happen. And we just walk in, and they're all like, what the hell are you doing here?
So yeah,
they were so disappointed. Yeah. I was so sorry for this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we kind of ruined the activity. But we did have an interesting debrief after that, where we talked about human trafficking.
Is it good or is it bad to sell human beings?
Where it happens, right? Like you wouldn't think of. When you think of a USA, you wouldn't think of human trafficking, right?
No, there are.
But there are, right? Yeah. And that was...
A lot of, like, darknet and how darknet will like expand in the future and
stuff. Yeah, as well in France, a lot of human traffic.
Like, yeah, people don't think about that when they walk down.
A big thanks to Aiden and Lena who have accepted to talk with me during this episode. Thanks also to the Alto Hostel and its staff for letting me record the podcast, and thank you for listening to it. I highly invite you to listen to the full episode of Random Conversation number 5 and the previous episode of Let's Talk Venture. You can also find other episodes of the podcast on YouTube, Spotify, Apple Podcast, PodCloud and the Internet Archive. You can follow my adventure on Instagram and Facebook, and all the links will be in the description. And if you've liked this episode, please share it and talk about it around you. Don't forget to subscribe, leave a thumbs up and 5 stars. I see you next Monday.